So in today's video, I'm going to be reviewing this WL Toys truck that seems to have a little bit of an identity crisis. Now, I know what you're thinking. Looking at the damage on the box, you'd probably assume that this truck has been involved in some kind of underground cage fighting with other RC brands to make a little extra money on the side as it made its way to my house. But that's just not the case at all. The truck is actually perfectly fine. So let's take it out of the box, have a bit of a look at it, go for a run, and see what it's got to offer. Big shout out to Cofago.com for sending out this truck for review. If you want to see what they have on offer, please be sure to check out the video description down below. I'll have a link to their website. And now back to the video. And here's the truck fully assembled and ready to go. Now, when you get one of these out of the box, you're going to find a few things. Of course, you're going to see the truck fully assembled and ready to go. You're going to get your radio, and there's also going to be a bag with manuals and a few bits and pieces in there that we'll go through very quickly. The first thing you're going to see is obviously a USB charger for the included battery in the truck. Now, this charger does not have an LED indicator or anything like that, and it only charges via the balance lead of the battery. The manual does say not to charge the battery for longer than 3 hours, so make sure you keep an eye on that. The next thing is going to be a wheelie bar that you will need to install on the truck. Now, this doesn't come pre-installed. I presume it has something to do with shipping. They do give you the screws to be able to fit the wheelie bar to the truck. There's also an instruction leaflet, which is written in Chinese, but you can use Google Translate to work out what everything says, which is kind of cool. And then, of course, you can just fit the wheelie bar to the truck. It literally takes about 2 minutes to do that. Not a big deal. The other thing, of course, you're going to see some tools to help you work on the truck. And, of course, the user manual. Now, the manual is very conflicting. On the front of the manual, it says that it's a 1/12 scale monster truck. But when you look inside, it actually says that it's a 1/10 scale monster truck. So it's a little bit confusing. I don't think this truck actually knows what size it's meant to be. Personally, I think it's a 1/12 scale because when you put it next to a proper 1/10 scale, like the Jump Shot MT, for example, this is actually a lot smaller. So that is pretty much what this thing is going to be. Don't let the box fool you. This is not 1/10 scale. It's more like 1/12 scale. So moving on to the radio itself, this is actually a nice little radio that came with this car. You have the on and off switch back here. There's a mode switch just there, which is inactive and doesn't actually do anything. You have steering trim just there, and you got throttle dual rate just here, which basically allows you to cap the top speed of the car. So when you pull the trigger, the car only goes as fast as you've set it here. So pretty good for young children or anybody that's fairly inexperienced and too used to these sort of vehicles. It'll allow you to slow the car down. Steering wheel just there, which actually doesn't feel too bad. It's nice and small, and it's got a foam little covering on it. And then, of course, the radio just works on 4 AA's, which is a pretty standard affair for these types of cars. And here we go. This is the truck itself. So let's have a better look at it. Speed Racing is what's written on the side there, in case you're wondering. Super fast, apparently. That's laying some pretty heavy claims. So watch out, all other brands who think they've got a fast vehicle. This one's super fast. You've got little plastic skid on the back of the body. Nice little touch. I like that. You do have pre-installed LEDs on the back here. These aren't just light buckets ready for LEDs. The LEDs are already pre-installed. Wheelie bar, which I installed earlier. You have LEDs on the front here as well. And you've also got LEDs on top here. And a nice little flexi bumper. I think the bumper's got LEDs. There's LEDs in there as well. And then, of course, you have your tires. Now, the only thing I don't like about this, I do love these wheels. I think the wheels look fantastic. But the tires don't have any foam inserts in them, which is kind of disappointing. I would have liked to have seen a little bit of foam in there. I don't know how this is going to go for grip. The tire does feel a little bit firm, and the side walls are quite firm as well. So this will likely concave in the middle. So I'm not sure about grip. It is running 12mm hexes though, so you can swap this out for whatever tires you like. I actually found that the Louise ST tires are a perfect fit and perfect size for this particular vehicle. I think it'll work quite well. As we flip it over, we can see the battery compartment just here and an on and off switch just there. The battery basically pinched those guys together and that just pops out. I don't know how long that's going to last being driven in dirt and having things getting stuck in there. We'll see what happens. Maybe for this particular one, you might want to keep it clean for the most part. And then you just pop that back in, just kind of push it in and make sure that those guys go all the way back and that holds your battery back in there. Aluminium arms. These aren't painted plastic arms. These are actual alloy arms. And you don't see ready-to-run vehicles with alloy arms very often. And there's a very logical reason for that, which I'll cover in this little show and tell. But first, we're going to take the body off. Well, partially take the body off, because the way they've done this, I mean, you probably could actually fully remove the body, but they've made it a little bit tricky. And let's just take it out. So you can see that you got all your wiring and everything going on here. And then you've got some hot glue that they've put here to stop the plugs from coming undone. And then there's some hot glue that they've put in there as well to stop those plugs from coming undone. So you could probably find a way to kind of unplug it. I mean, that probably does come off. But just be a little careful when you are handling this guy. Don't just yank the body clean off, because yeah, that might cause you some problems there. We have a 2-in-1 speed controller. So this is both a receiver and a speed controller there. We have an opening here for your cable to go to into the battery tray. Standard 550 size motor, I believe that's a 550 size. And it looks like it's already got a little bit of rust on it, but it's not a big deal because it does work. I have tested it. And then you have a no-name brand steering servo up here. It is a standard size with a plastic servo horn. So if you do want to upgrade the servo, it's pretty straightforward. Shouldn't be any problems there. Do not drive this through water. I wouldn't go saying that this is splash proof or waterproof. I think the servo will pretty much die if it does get wet. Although they have put some hot glue in the switches here and some things, I really don't trust this splashing through water. So just be a little mindful there. And then that's pretty much it. Now, you have threaded bodied aluminium shocks all the way around. That's really cool. As long as these guys aren't made out of butter, I think that's a really cool addition, more so than the alloy arms. Personally, I really like that. Gear covers back here, of course. We have steel drive shafts all the way around. And one of the really interesting things that I noticed as well, they've actually included droop screws on these A-arms. They're hidden under there, but this is a plastic little tab that's here. So I don't know that these tabs are actually going to sustain or, you know, cause any resistance for you to adjust the height of the vehicle using those droop screws, because, well, it's plastic, you know, any pressure on there is just going to flex. So I don't know if that's actually going to be a good thing. These body posts are really flimsy, which I guess is both a good thing and a bad thing, because, well, you're unlikely to break them if you take a hit, but it does make it somewhat tricky. And I've tried to do this several times to put the body back on. And sometimes I get it fairly quickly. Sometimes I spend like 2 minutes trying to get the body on, and it's a little bit frustrating. But that's really the only complaint I have regarding that. I don't know how good this body is going to be. I don't know how good this truck is going to be with the alloy arms. Before we move on, let's talk about alloy arms in RCs. On more than one occasion, I've been asked about alloy arms. Why can't you get alloy arms? Put them on your favorite basher, go out there and have fun, and you won't have, you know, break arms anymore. There is a reason why a lot of bashers don't have aluminium arms. And the reason for that is the arms, having plastic arms allows some flex. It allows a bit of a give point for when you have some hard impacts and things like that. It also protects your steering knuckles, but most importantly, it also protects your hinge pin holders and your bulkheads in here, diff housings, all of those sorts of things. Because when you take a hit on a wheel, right, if the arm is as stiff as this is, all the force is going to go straight into that steering knuckle. Now, if the steering knuckle survives, that's all good and well, but then the leverage of the impact is going to travel up, and it's going to go straight into these hinge pins and eventually try to rip those off out of, you know, your bulkheads and things like that. Having plastic arms, as long as it's a good durable plastic that has some flexibility in it, for the average basher is actually a good thing. Having alloy is not necessarily a good thing for bashers. And I can tell you from experience and from several people that have used this, you know, gone for the alloy option thinking it's gonna be super tough, but it really isn't. And even if none of these components break, you still have the potential to bend the arm, which in which case it's as bad as breaking a plastic arm anyway, except now you've got a bent, expensive aluminium arm. Although these may not be expensive, I don't know, but just referring to just in general. So alloy arms on a basher, I'm not too sure. You know, for a road car or a speed car, if you want to bling it up a little bit, something that does, you know, it's unlikely to have massive impacts, sure, no worries. But if you're out in the dirt, taking jumps, doing backflips, colliding with other people, whatever, this isn't necessarily a good thing. At least from my point of view. You can disagree if you wish, but from my experience and from what I've seen, alloy arms aren't always necessarily a good thing. All that being said, they are included with this truck. It's a fairly low price point. And, you know, let's talk about the styling a little bit. We all know what this kind of looks like. It looks like one of those trucks from that brand that has a car that kind of rhymes with Ajax. And the roof skids up here kind of resemble that car from the same brand that rhymes with Hustler and Stevo. So, you know, they've actually, you know, the imitation is the best form of flattery. So I think this actually doesn't look too bad at all. Whether or not this is actually going to be pretty good or not, let's find out. Let's take it for a rip. Let's see what this thing's got to offer. And we'll come back, we'll assess.
Now, it has been a hot minute since I have been out this way. The old stomping ground. I figured this was a nice little place to get a sense of what this thing's going to be like, how fast it is. And there's a couple of little jumps here we can try as well. You can see those LEDs on the front there, very bright, even in the early morning sun. It's not bad. I mean, look, I tell you what, for the road, this actually isn't bad at all. Brakes are really strong. I'll give you a heads up. You can see there, the brakes are super strong, very sensitive. Not much grip if you hammer it. Not much grip if you hammer it around the bends, because it just spins out. But if you ease it around the corners, it actually does pretty well. You can see there. Whoop-a! Now, of course, if you are finding this to be too quick, you can turn down your top speed by dialing it back here. So let's see if we go all the way down. Wow, that's full speed now with the dial all the way down. So no donuts or burnouts. That is pegged. That's as fast as it'll go. So that's pretty good. This is with the included battery. Now as I turn up that dial, there it is. So that's full speed again. This is all right. I mean, it's probably doing, I don't know, maybe 35-ish Ks, maybe 40. I'll try and get a top speed reading of it. I got my GPS charging up as we speak, so hopefully we'll get something out of it. Do a couple of runs around here. All right, so that pretty much shows us what it'll do on tarmac. Let's see what it'll do off-road. So as you can see, they've kind of ruined this area. There's a big puddle over there, which is not really good. We've got to avoid that. But there's too many jumps here now. A lot of overgrown grass. And yeah, this is where RC Carnage was held last. And we can't do that anymore. But for this little guy, just to see what he can do, I think this is going to be all right. We'll be able to see some durability. No doubt I'm going to crash it. And, there it is. And hopefully we'll get some, there we go, got some jumps. Funny thing with this thing is that it has, there we go. Nope, not into the mud. Funny thing with this guy is that it has a wheelie bar, but it really has no way of doing wheelies with this sort of power. Yeah, the cute little thing. Oh, we got a stick. We have a stick. That's all right, it's gone. Let's see if we can line up a nice big full throttle. Oh, nice. I do like those LEDs. Very bright. This thing's alright. Like, for a bit of mucking around, this is not bad. Oh no! Oh, thank God. It's been pretty lucky with it. Hasn't tipped over on me. Oh! Oh no, I'm... What am I, on a rock? Must be. I'm stuck somewhere. Alright, let's try it here. Slightly bigger jump. A little smoother though. Oh! Can be a bit tricky to line this up. That jump would have been perfect, but there's a big puddle on the other side. Oh. Tell you what, it still goes through most things. Tire grip is not as bad as I was expecting, to be honest. I mean, sure, this isn't a brushless power system, so it's not like we have excess power here. Let's see if I can line this up here and... That wasn't bad. It's such a cute little car. Actually, let me see if I can line up from that side. Oh, I can get up there. And let's try this. We go from here. And... Oh no, doesn't quite allow me to line up. I think just through the guts here is probably the best way so far. Full speed. Alright, let's kick up some dirt over this side. Still a little bit of gravel around here, which is really good for us to have some fun with. Yeah, this is all right. Quite a bit of a muck around car. This thing goes pretty good. Love those LEDs. Very cool. Servo's really slow, I'm noticing, like, struggling to keep this thing in a straight line. And then you correct, and then it swings back the other way, and before you know it, you have overcorrected. So you can see me swaying, that's just me trying to correct it. It just has trouble centering, so the servo's really weak. When you do get it, oh, well look, the lights are flashing, that means LVC. There we go, that's LVC. That's how you know it's time to recharge your battery. And yeah, we're pretty much done with this guy. So there you have it. Not a bad way to let you know that the battery's done, having the lights flashing like that. I have no throttle at all. Still have steering though. But that wasn't too bad at all. Probably got about 10 minutes out of the stock battery, which isn't too bad. And that pretty much wraps up this video.
So overall, I actually didn't mind this car. I think it's actually pretty good. Definitely one of the better features that it has is the LED lights already pre-installed. The fact that it has a USB charger, it's got a battery already in the box, pretty much you're ready to go with the exception of the four AA's you need for the radio. This is actually not a bad truck at all. It did reasonably well. Sure, the tires weren't the best as I suspected. I did have a little bit of trouble sort of getting up over those jumps. But I think with a better set of tyres, especially something like a Louise ST tyre, like an uphill or something like that, I think it'll do really, really well. Of course, you can always make the servo a little better. And if you really want to spend the money, you could probably throw a brushless system in here. Although I don't know if that's really going to be worth your while in the long run. I think for what it is, the truck actually did quite well. And I'm happy to report, I really don't have too many complaints. Now, I will say that... you can run this on a 2S LiPo, and I did that. I ran it on a 2200 2S, which is these little iRuns batteries that I have here. These come with an XT60, so I just used a little adapter in there for the time being. Now, to fit this in, you have to put the power cable in through the hole in the battery tray and actually connect the battery on top of the chassis, not inside the actual battery tray. But you can run something like this, 2200 milliamp versus a 1500 milliamp. Being 2S LiPo as well, you're gonna have a little bit more punch out of that, especially with something like a 30C or above like this one is. And it actually performed quite well. Top speed was about, I think, 35 kilometers an hour, just running up and down my driveway. And that was actually going downhill. So I don't know where they're claiming 45 kilometers an hour on the box, unless, of course, you change out the gearing. But it's actually pretty decent speed overall. And the truck actually did quite well. So that's going to do it for this video. Don't forget to check out the video description down below, where I have a link to the Kafago website where you can check out the products that they have on offer. If you have any questions or queries, please be sure to leave them in the comment section down below and I'll do my best to get back to you. And as always, thank you all very much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to hit that thumbs up button. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you're new, and I'll be speaking to you all next time.